this because you're going to love this. Today for your garden, using planter and pots to full effect. We all love colorful patio pots, but there's no need to crowd them onto your deck or your patio. Gardening guru Linda Vodder is here to show us how to incorporate them into your flower beds. And look at my new best friend. Can you see that little? Look at that.
It's a corsage for you because it looks so cute. Beautiful with your jacket.
A fake butterfly. That's what I needed in my life. Why would we take pots off of the patio or the deck to put it in the garden?
Well, we're not necessarily stealing from Peter to pay Paul, but let me give you a perfect example of this. Okay, so I've got a big bare spot or a void in my garden where I want to put something else to grow, and I would really like to have hydrangeas there. But there's way too much root competition from shrubs that are already in place, from other things that are already in the garden. So I could put a large pot in there that I keep in there pretty permanently in place. I can then put the plants inside that pot. They have room to grow in that massive pot. And the other nice thing about it is they're now at a level that is much higher where I can see them and enjoy them versus down low at ground level. And I'm not having to contend with the root competition from other plants. So that's one reason.
Okay, let me ask you one practical question. Okay. I don't mean to interrupt, but can you overwinter them in those pots?
In this instance, yes, I can, because it's one of those faux terracotta pots that's weatherproof. It's massive enough, and that's a very good point. If I could, the takeaway from this should be most of the time you want them to be, if they're permanent pots, you want them to be very large. So they're like small gardens.
Oh, okay.
And you're not a slave to watering them. Another consideration is if you're not going to be there to provide supplemental watering, then you might want to attach some kind of drip line from your existing irrigation system if you have it so that it can water itself. Another thing is quite frequently on those kind of pots, they're sitting in the flower beds and sometimes roly-polies, things like that can crawl up through the holes. One way to alleviate that and to give it even more stature, even more height, is to put them up on pot feet or elevate them again on some kind of wrought iron stand.
Okay.
It's another great way to infuse. We've done this at your house where you want some kind of pop of color or brightness in an area that's dark and shady and there's just no way really to get it. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to be entertaining, if you want, you know, for a photo shoot, just for temporary beautification, you want to just pop in a spot of color. You can do that with a lightweight pot. You can just temporarily put it in there and you can enjoy it for, you know, for that period of time. And it also gives you flexibility. So you can move something around. If right now, at this point in time where the sun is, this plant might be very happy.
Yeah.
Later in July, it might be way too hot for that exposure, but because it's in a pot and not in the ground, you just pick it up and you move it to another location where you can enjoy it.
Now, you're talking about a big pot. Is this what you consider a big pot?
Well, this I would say is just a medium pot, and let's also point out, this is an evergreen, or it gives the stature of an evergreen, because you might have, let's say, a big bank of roses.
Right.
The roses are done, or you have a big bank of hydrangeas, or tulips, or whatever, and they're all finished, and there's not much visual interest there, and it's just a deciduous plant that might, you know, might not really hold much form. So you can put an evergreen in there, in a pot, put it in place, and immediately you have architecture that otherwise would take a long time for that plant to reach maturity. So you could do this with a large boxwood shrub.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, with something of that nature. These, like this one, for example, would look great sitting in this stand. It would be a beautiful punctuation point. It also provides kind of a stopping point and a focal point for your eye against all of the abundant greenery in the beds. You have a beautiful pot or something to focus your eye on.
And did this come from a thrift store? Because that's usually where she gets all of her
Stands. You can get these at Home Depot. You can get them almost anywhere. They're relatively inexpensive. I think this one was about $11, but it's really great. The other nice thing about it is if that pot is very heavy at all, when you're putting it in place, you don't have to bend over so far to put it in place or lift it out.
Protect your back.
You betcha.
There you go. Now, you can get a lot of gardening ideas on Linda's Instagram and her blog, which is fabulous, lindavodder.com. Thank you for coming.
Sure.
Have a good weekend.